Hey, Spanish learners. In today's lesson, we're going to give you all the tips and tools that you need in order to go to a market and to buy stuff. You're not going to want to miss this. Let's go.
How are you, friends? So today we're gonna learn about the vocabulary that we use for el supermercado and mercado. Yes, supermercado and mercado. Let's see what are the differences. Do you know some? No? Okay. Supermercado, normally in Latin America, tenemos, we use for food like this. Comida like this. Por ejemplo, agua and leche. Mercado. Okay, in Latin America, it's most common to buy this comida. Por ejemplo, vegetables, and frutas, and others. It's most common for us in Latin America to buy those products, esta comida, food, comida, en el mercado, en descomida, en el supermercado. En Latinoamérica, let's see what are la comida that we buy en el supermercado and el mercado. Remember the difference. En el supermercado, we mostly buy agua. Compramos, remember to buy, compramos agua. Leche, café, pan, panqueques, queso, chocolate, jugo de frutas, arroz. Those products are most common that we buy, compramos en el supermercado. We say, compras del supermercado. Remember the products. La comida. En el mercado. Sí, mercado. In Latin America is most common. Vegetales and frutas. Vegetales, vegetables, and frutas. Fruits. Also, we can buy, nosotros compramos, carne, meat, pescado, fish. Let's see what are the vegetales en español. Cebolla, zanahoria, tomate. And let's see las frutas. Manzana, pera, bananos, naranja, sandía. Uvas, manzana. Let's see what other product that is not vegetal or fruta that we can buy, compramos en el mercado. Carne, meat, pescado, fish. What are those? Yes, muy bien. Okay. So now, if I want to ask for some, I will say, quiero. Do you remember what is quiero en español? I want, quiero. So you can say, quiero leche, quiero pan, quiero panqueques, quiero queso. Or, en el mercado, quiero cebolla, and quiero zanahoria, quiero tomate. So now it's your turn. Do you remember how you can ask for those en el supermercado or el mercado? Remember? Say it with me. Yes. Muy bien. Agua or leche. So what you choose? Agua or leche en el supermercado. Okay, you choose leche. Quiero leche. Quiero leche. And now en el mercado. What do you want? Vegetal or fruta? ¿Qué quieres? Vegetal or fruta? Fruta. And now choose one fruta en español. ¿Qué fruta we have en español? Sandía, banano, pera, manzana, naranja. ¿Qué quieres? Good. You choose naranja. So you say, quiero naranja. Repeat. Muy bien. Very good. Now we wanna use the vocabulary sentences in a complete phrase. Okay? So that we can use en el mercado, mostly, or en el supermercado. Disculpa. Excuse me. ¿Me puedes ayudar con vegetales, por favor? ¿Dónde está la leche y el pan? Gracias. Quiero vegetales y frutas. So, how I can pay? In cash, efectivo, or tarjeta de crédito, credit card. I can put mis vegetales and frutas in mi canasta. Or agua, pan, leche, queso en mi carreta, cart. Please, all those, todo esto, en mi bolsa, bag, en mi bolsa. So with that we can use en el supermercado or el mercado. Remember that. Now we have a very important question that we use en el mercado. Because in el mercado, we don't have the prices showing us. ¿Cuánto cuesta? How much is this? ¿Cuánto cuesta? We use en el mercado because we need to ask for each product that we want. Que yo quiero. Por ejemplo, ¿cuánto cuesta la cebolla? ¿Cuánto cuesta el tomate? ¿Cuánto cuesta los vegetales? And now here we have a tip and trick. In Latin America, mostly the answer will be, oh, por ejemplo, for example, tomate, 3 por 10. 3 for 10. For example, por ejemplo, 3 tomates por 10. Wow. 3 tomates por 10. That is very common in los vegetales and frutas. For example, 4 for 10. Manzana, 4 manzanas por 10. So you buy 4 manzanas and you pay en efectivo, cash, 10. 10. Okay? ¿Cuánto cuesta? ¿Cuánto cuesta las peras? ¿Cuánto cuestan las peras? So the answer mostly is 3 por 10. Remember that tip and trick? 3 peras por 10. Ok. ¿Cuánto cuestan las zanahorias? ¿Cuánto cuestan las zanahorias? 3 zanahorias por 10. That is very common en el mercado en Latin America. Okay, guys, so that's all that we have for today. So, see you en el mercado. Adios!
Hey, guys, thanks for watching. I really, really hope you like this video. Our question of the day is, how do you learn best? Are you an auditory learner? Or perhaps a more visual learner, or even tactile? Let us know in the comments below. If you're ready to take your Spanish to the next level, feel free to take a free class with one of our awesome and great instructors. Just visit us at www.spanish.academy/free-class, and we teach Spanish one-on-one in a very personalized way depending on how you learn best. Additionally, it's an incredibly flexible program so you can schedule your classes around your busy life. Take your first step towards fluency today. Adios!